your thoughts when you walk Robert back after the fourth round after the knockdown?
Well, I knew he was going to come back from that knockdown, so he just had to get his composure back and get focused, you know. And I told him not to get into the ropes, you know, but, you know, it happened, you know. And, you know, when your mind's not focused right, you know, things happen. Your mind's not there. Cause you know what happened with my knees and stuff. You know, I knew, you know, I had to wake them up out of it. You know what I mean? I have to stay strong and you know, I did what I could do to bring him back into the fight. You know.
What did you tell him after the fourth round? It looked like he was out on his feet. What did you tell him?
When he came back, he looked okay. You know, he took the standing count. He came back and I looked at him. I go, "You okay?" He goes, "Yeah, Dad, I'm okay." I go, "All right, let's get to work. Start getting in the middle of the ring. Start boxing. You know, let's do a little bit of boxing. You know."
So he calls you Dad in the corner.
Huh?
He calls you Dad in the corner.
Jefe.
Oh, he calls you Jefe in the corner.
Jefe de los jefes.
Now, half of the audience booed, half of the audience cheered when they heard 97, 92.
Yeah.
Mr. Guerrero, what were your thoughts? Was that fair?
This is his hometown. You know what I mean? You know, this is his hometown. He's from here, so you know everybody. It's gonna happen no matter what. When you're in somebody else's backyard, bro, you know, they're not gonna be happy. Especially if it's like a little close one, they're not gonna be happy. So
moving forward, how soon do you want to get him back in the ring?
Maybe by September.
September.
Yeah, we'll be okay. Ready again.
Let me ask you a tough question. As his dad, he's been knocked down twice in his last two fights, and he's never been knocked down before.
Yeah.
Do you have any concerns?
I have a little bit of concern, but you know, it's one of those things, man, that, you know, you got to put it behind you, and we got to go to work, man, you know, and that's it. You know, he's a warrior, and that's what makes you tougher. You get dropped like that, you get tougher, you know.
So, September, who do you want to see in September?
Well, whoever, we're going to get together, the whole team, and we're going to figure it out, see where we're going to go from there, you know.
Okay.
So, and hopefully it's a big, mega fight, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, but I really wanted a 12-rounder. Because I think towards the 12th round, I think we would have took him out. Because Robert was hurting him already towards the 12th round.
Well, I had it. Well, like I told you the other day.
Yeah.
I thought he was going to be out in the fourth.
Yeah.
I was wrong.
Well, some of these guys are tough. That's why I didn't say nothing. You know what I mean? Because these guys working so hard.
It's their Super Bowl.
Yeah. It's like a Super Bowl game. They don't got nothing to lose.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? They'll throw whatever they got. They'll train hard. And if they win or they get put up a good fight, they're going to get another big opportunity. So, you know, hey, that's like you're hitting the lotto, man, you know? Shit. So they're going to train hard no matter what. These guys come to fight.
Well, again, great comeback. Congratulations on the win, and we look forward to seeing you on behalf of everyone else. Wish you happy Father's Day, and thank you for what you're doing for your father and what you're doing for boxing. Appreciate you, brother.
Thank you very much.